Now, this concerto, very unusual. Well, it seems to be very unusual because it only uses one hand. Yeah. The story behind that, you know the story behind that. Can you tell us the story behind that?
So Paul Wittgenstein was a concert pianist, and he lost his right arm in World War I, but he still wanted to continue performings. So he was going through all of the left-hand repertoire and commissioning noted composers of the 20th century like Benjamin Britten, Paul Hindemith, Richard Strauss, I think, and Ravel. And Ravel, in the meantime, was thinking of being a concert pianist himself. He was working on the concerto in G, the two-hand concerto, in the meantime, and he got this commission, and it was just too irresistible to pass up. And it was the ultimate challenge for him because he wanted the concerto to sound like it was, you could almost hear three hands as opposed to only one. So it's, I think, one of the most challenging concertos ever written.
Maybe we should have a little excerpt from it. I think the opening's perfect because the opening, to me, it comes out of this really dark, dark, dark place. It starts with the double basses. You can barely discern what they're playing. It's just sort of...
And it just expands. It just goes up and up and up.
And a contrabassoon solo. Very rare to have a contrabassoon solo. And then the piano emerges out of this. With this, it's almost a defiant flourish. It's like, look what I can do with just one hand. Nice. That's like...
Et cetera.
I've never been that close to a piano. And when somebody's been doing that, that's quite amazing. That's more than I can do with two hands. Quite easily, quite handily.
And that's one of the easier parts of the piece.
Easier parts of the piece, too, because you have to, you know, fit in. That's a cadenza passage that you're playing on your own. So you have a little bit more freedom than when you have to fit in with this massive...
Yes, massive orchestration and being heard beyond that that huge mass behind me is another challenge. So, a lot of weightlifting was required.
Silly question. Do you get lopsided practicing this concerto? Do your right hand get kind of bored and... What do you do with your right hand when you're working on this concerto?
Well, after the left-hand concerto, I also play through the Brahms' second concerto, which is a piece I'm going to be performing next week. So both hands are occupied right now. Yeah.
Excellent. I'll tell you a funny story. The last time we played this was Krzysztof Strablonski, and he had a young toddler with him at the time. His son was like, you know, maybe this tall. And when he was warming up backstage, he had his son on his lap with his right arm sort of restraining his son around his son. And he was practicing with the left hand. And it was the perfect concerto. And we had this horn player in the orchestra at the time who was kind of a character. He's now in the Berlin Philharmonic of all places now. And he came up to him and said, dude, you should totally get one of those big foam fingers like they have at the football games with Ravel number one written on it. And
yes,
just be like
I
doing
like that.
That, especially for that opening passage. I don't know. You're probably not ready to do anything like that here just yet. Maybe.
Well, I'm up to a dare.
You're up to a dare. Okay. Well.